It's about painstaking craftsmanship. It's about the teamwork required to place a dream on film. To make my Tauntaun move, a miniature of her with a model of me aboard had to be created. That was then photographed one frame at a time through a process known as stop motion photography at our special effects studio near San Francisco.
Okay. Shooting.
It takes Dennis Muren and Phil Tippett an hour just to make 1 second of stop motion film. The adjustments between frames of all the tiny moving parts are minuscule, but projected at the proper speed, 24 frames per second, these individual movements will flow seamlessly together. They're actually models which can be carried in the palm of your hand. They were filmed against background paintings and snowscapes months later. The models came in several sizes to match the scale of different live-action shots. The artificial snow is made out of baking soda and microscopic glass bubbles. It took 9 months to design and build these models. Dennis Muren does the stop-motion photography. The animator is John Byrd. Once again, each articulated part of the model must be moved. No more than a fraction of an inch between each single frame exposure in these stop-motion sequences. The animators shot motion studies of animals in order to perfect the movements of their models. The snowwalkers followed in this elephant's footsteps. Because the live-action footage was finished before most of the special effects were completed, animated sketches, animatics, of the finished sequence were made. They served as moving blueprints for the film editor and the effects people. Orchestration, an artful blending of all the elements in a sequence, is everything in a film like Empire. The pilot's point of view, as they attacked the snowwalkers, was shot on a specially developed camera. It's linked to a computer that remembers each move precisely so that it can be repeated as often as necessary. The television monitor allows the motion control camera operators to see precisely what the camera is seeing and make whatever adjustments are necessary in rehearsal. The speeder's flybys were done with models against a blue screen. The blue screen provides a neutral background so that still more elements can be added to the shot later. This speeder is one of the planes taking part in the snow battle. What the special effects people are doing under Richard Edlund's direction is arranging for it to be blown out of the sky.
Okay, why don't we hit the blue screen? Okay, that's, okay, right there. Okay, back up to next position.
This model is specially constructed so that it can carry a small explosive charge and break apart when it's fired.
All right, let her go.
The explosion will be triggered electrically.
Bang!
Yeah, right? That's it. Okay, should we load it?
The explosive charge is a secret concoction formulated to explode spectacularly and burn colorfully. The shot will be made by a high-speed camera that will, in effect, extend the shot so that the small model will look like a full-scale plane under realistic attack.
Set her down easy.
The special effects team has worked 8 hours to create this shot. It will last just over 1 second on screen.
Is there anybody not ready? Everything's armed, ready to go.
Okay. Light the smoke. Okay, let her go.
To make sure the shot is recorded and to give the editor a choice of angles, it is covered by several cameras. This is how the shot was worked into the final sequence. When it has to fly, or seem to, it's a model that's set in motion against a blue screen. The largest of them weighs close to 200 pounds and is 4 feet in diameter. There's another one 2 feet across. Very good for navigating an asteroid field. Yet another is just 5 inches in size. The smallest is only 2 inches. Which one to use in a shot is determined by the scale of other objects in the scene. To place a ship in motion in space, a model is shot against a blue screen. This shot is later combined with other elements also photographed against a blue screen, like this Star Destroyer. The Falcon being hit. Each approaching asteroid also had to be shot separately against a blue screen and then combined. A blue screen's blue registers clear when printed on black and white film. From this film, 2 mats are created, one black on white, the other white on black. Superimposed on separate pieces of color film in printing, one mat generated by the blue screen prevents the foreground object from registering. The other does the same for the background. All the different elements created through blue screen photography must be perfectly aligned when the final composite color print is made. When all that work is done, a background and a foreground shot many months or miles apart can be joined undetectably.